Everyone, myself Professor M.S. Goethe, Assistant Professor of Department of Agricultural Entomology, KKWA College of Agriculture, Nashik. In today's lecture, we study the pest of guava under the course number N2243 and course title is Pest of Horticultural Crops and Their Management. In today's lecture, we are only studying the major pest of guava. These are the major pest of guava. First one is fruit fly, then spiraling white fly, bark eating caterpillar, fruit borer of guava, green scale of guava, and last one is mealybug of guava. The first and major pest of guava is fruit fly, that is Pactrocera diversus. It belongs to order Diptera and family is Tripetidae. When the pest belongs to order Diptera, then the damaging stage is always maggots. Maggots means nothing but the legless larva. So here we can see the adult fly in first image, then pupa, and the in last image we can see the maggots or legless larva of the fruit fly. Then host plant of this pest. This pest is a polyphagous and feeds on the mango as well as guava, pomegranate, citrus and banana. The next point is life history. The eggs deposited under the rind of the fruit and the pupation takes place inside the soil and the carryover stage of this pest is adult. The next point is nature of damage. Firstly, the adult flies cause punctures in the fruits for oviposition, and then after hatching from the eggs, maggots bore into the semi-ripened fruits with decayed spots and feed on the pulp. Later, a brownish rotten patch makes its appearance on the surface of the attacked fruits. Then, infested fruits start rotting and the fruit eventually drop down when the maggots come out and enter the soil for pupation. So these are the nature of damage by this pest. So in images we can see the maggots feeding inside the fruit. Then next point is management practices. Firstly, orchard sanitation means daily removal and destruction of fallen and affected fruits and dispose these fruits by dumping in a pit. Also provide the summer ploughing to expose the pupa of this pest. Then if the trees are few in number, then follow the bagging of the fruits with the cloth or paper bags. Also we can monitor the activity of fruit fly population in orchards by using the methylogenol or also called as rakshak trap. Then the spread of this destructive pest can be prevented only by applying strict quarantine measures. Then we can also use the spray bed. Then also we can use the chemotropic oils and chemicals. Then application of suitable spray with the oils. So these are the management practices for the control of fruit fly. Then second major pest of guava is spiraling white fly, that is Alaeroricus dispersus. They having the family Alaeroridae and order is Hemiptera. Hence the damaging stage is always nymphs and adults. Host plant of this pest. This pest is polyphagous in nature, means feeding on the number of plants. Then these are the three different life stages of this pest. First one the eggs, then nymphs are also called as crawlers. And in last image we can see the adult of spiraling white fly. Then life history. Oviposition and pupation both on underside of the leaves. Then next point is how this pest damage to the plant. Damage to the crop is caused by both nymphs and adults by sucking the cell sap, secreting honeydew like substance and further creating sooty molds on the leaves. As a result, photosynthetic activities, growth of the plant and fruit setting is adversely affected, and the infected leaves become yellow, dry and ultimately drop down. So here we can see the damaging symptoms on the leaves by spiraling whitefly in spirals or in spiraling pattern. Then management practices. Firstly, release of Encarsia parasitoids at the rate of 1 lakh per hectare. Then also we can use the yellow streaky traps. Then during heavy infestation, application of imidacloprid or triazophos or malathion or diflobenzuron. Then third major pest of guava is bark eating caterpillar. So these are the two species of the bark eating caterpillar. First one is Indarbela quadrinotata and second one is Indarbela tetraonis. Both species belongs to family Derbilidae and order is Lepidoptera. Hence the damaging stage is always larva or caterpillar. Life history of these both species is eggs deposited on the bark and the pupation takes place inside the larval tunnel. And the number of generation of this pest is 1 per year. So here we can see the adult and larva of the both species of bark eating caterpillar. The nature of damage. Firstly, the larva bore into wood making short tunnels in which they hide during the day and come out at night to feed on the bark. As a result of feeding on a bark, the sap conducting tissues are damaged, which interrupt the translocation of the cell sap. Also, the frass and silken threads over the bark surface form the webbing. The growth and fruit setting is adversely affected. Also, the withering of branches by this pest. So, in image, we can see the damage done by the larva of bark eating caterpillar. So these are also damaging symptoms on the bark or on the branches by the bark eating caterpillar. Then next is management practices. Firstly, remove the ribbon like silken webs from the affected branches or trunks. Then detect the larval tunnel and insert the iron spike into it to kill the larva. Then inject the CS2 or borer solution. Then spot application or spraying of monocrotophos or dichlorophos or also quinalphos and fenvalerate. So these are the management practices for bark eating caterpillar. Then third major pest of guava is fruit borer. Firstly, the Congenthes punctiferalis and second species is Deodorix isocretus. So these are the two species of fruit borer. It belongs to family Lycaenidae and order is Lepidoptera. So first species is Congenthes punctiferalis. So this is the larva and adult of fruit borer. The species is Congenthes punctiferalis. So this is the second species, that is Deodorix isocretus. Then the third species is Rapala varuna. Life history of these three species. The eggs deposited on flower buds or young shoots or on the fruits, and the pupation takes place inside the fruit or also on fruit stalk or in plant debris at the foot of the plant. Then nature of damage. Caterpillars bore into the fruits feed on the pulp and the seeds. Then damaged fruits subsequently get infected by the bacteria and resulting into the rotting of the fruits. Such rotten fruits give offensive smell and fall down. Also, the excreta of larva around the entry hole are seen. They also feed on the flowers and the shoots. So here we can see the infested fruits by this pest. Then next point is management practices. Firstly, the collect and destroy damaged fruits. Then clean cultivation as a weed plants serve as an alternate host. Then also use the light trap 1 per hectare to monitor the activity of adults. Then spray with endoxacarb, also spinosad, also cypermethrin. Then bagging of fruits if the number of fruits or trees is limited. So these are all about this fruit borer. Then next pest of the guava is mealybug, or also called as tail mealybug. The scientific name of this pest is Fersia viriata. It belongs to family Pseudococcidae and having the order Hemiptera. Hence the damaging stage is nymphs and adults. So here we can see the egg masses on the leaves. Then next is the nature of damage. Nymphs and adult female remains cluster on the ventral surface of the leaves, terminal shoots, and sometimes on the fruit and serve the cell sap. Yellowing of leaves and premature shedding of fruits occurs. Then next point is management practices for mealybug. Firstly, spray with 0.1% acephate or monocrotophos or also the carbaryl. Then spray with the biopesticide like verticillium lecani 0.2%, or also we can use the predator Cryptolemus montreuseri beetles at the rate of 10 per tree. These are the minor pests, that is green scale. So in today's lecture we have studied the pest of guava. Thank you.